Hello everyone, it's H-Tombo2 and we had to test this microphone for this video today. We just set up some open podcast, or just set up some recording stuff. So just a little setup to make an upgrade, and of course my microphone's here. So finally I can talk for now, and apparently we can do that for now. And yeah, and of course we're gonna react to Analysis Bernie Reacts to Legend of Everfree. And yeah, made by Cell Spanx. It finally just arrived now. And now today we're gonna react. The same thing I did for react to Ace of Red's Best for Bernie React, and I did it so well, but also I did the result. But I didn't get the rest of the pictures. You know, like, Ace of Red's Best just, you know, cropped it all for the videos. And I went to see, like, everyone's so, so excited and overreacted by this problem. And yeah, of course, the video will be linked in the description, the channel link description, and of course my microphone will be started the first day in this microphone, and of course 2007, yay, we can do it right now. So anyways, and remember last time, also if someone having a little like a question or acting, even a video I haven't tried or anything, like the same thing the other rats do, like teen rats or anything, yeah, like this happened before. So let's start it anyway. Let's start in 3, 2, 1, go. For today. Dr. Wolf, Legend Everfree, a little question for the girl movie. Dr. Wolf,
is it that time again?
Yes,
it's that time again.
It's that time again! Ow, my ears! Sorry, it's just because of the microphone.
Okay, I guess it's that time again.
Okay, I got my Zac Brown Band camo hat.
Wait, voice of reason, hey, and what the heck is Zap Boy's hat before? I got like pointy hats in my room, and like, I wear it all the day, you know.
Got my thermos of water.
Okay.
Oh, yes, my anti-slasher villain spray.
Only a Sephardy from the targets. And apparently that's a bit a problem.
I'm ready for this camping movie.
Yep.
Okay, it's time for a new request.
Stupid Private 913. Still this guy. And the derpy eyes and an America flag. Hallelujah.
Tria girls, and this time we're off to summer camp. Let's see if I'm packed. Rubber ducky? Check. Pup tent.
Ooh,
check. Protection from magical monstrosities from Equestria.
Thief.
Check.
Oh.
And mate.
Did you say check and mate? This rhymes like this. And Toon Credit fee 2K. I'll just call Toon Credit for now. Apparently, Toon Credit got changed or lost area before the old version of I reacted the first one. So yeah, I think it's a dead very well if you get new ones.
Ladies and germs, it's time for another one of these. You know who I am, so let's do this. This should be fun, hopefully. I've heard a few good things about this, so yeah, let's do this.
Yeah,
girls.
Sketchy. And whoa, this man, it's got, he got glasses and a set up, and he's got an orange hood. But I think he's got a good clothes today, and him. Was he? I never heard him before. The Sketchy, the Changeling. Yeah, I think I just watched Sketchy Changeling did it, like Kevin. Yep. I'm gonna talk to Kevin. Like, God damn it, Kevin.
4. Didn't like the first one. Love the second one. I like the third one, but not as good as the second one. So not sure what to think about number 4.
He says the number 4 is like, is that bad or good? You're the judge.
Well, we're about to find out.
Thou shalt not complain
in Cell Spanx. Apparently he's the one who created the analysis reacts, and mostly a lot. So yeah.
About flesh. Thou shalt not complain endlessly about flesh.
There we go, got my
raisin. I never heard him before, but we didn't check anything.
Designated waifu t-shirt on.
Waifu?
Brony. Let's do this.
You love Sunset Shimmer with Senpai Notice. You should call Senpai, you know. And Do Wheaton, Vespio.
So, Equestria Girls 4, Legend of Everfree, huh? You know,
Who wants to bet that this world's Everfree will actually pose a legitimate threat, unlike the one in the show, given its track record?
Not exactly a good point. Oh.
Yeah, right!
New N out of this Brony 3X.
And NY. Yep, again. He's here again. Everyone loves NY, and apparently he wants to be funny. So anyways, that part.
You know what that means.
No.
Transformation time!
Oh my god. My ears. Hold on. I have to turn down a bit. About 50. There we go. Doctor Who reference. This is not exactly Damon. And sorry about that, but it just... My microphone had the... That thing.
Okay, you got me. I just wanted to reuse my Doctor Who opening. I only got...
Yeah, you already did it like Doctor Who, but why don't it do the transformation, but the Doctor Who?
To use it 3 times!
About... No, I think about like 4 or 6.
Fine. I'm changing my other stuff.
And now it's a brand new react. Apparently a lot of people in. Production by Sesame. You know. You know? Yeah. Intro by going for Dynagshy. You know, this picture's a really good phrase for this one. Except unfortunately there's no keyframe or Golden Fox in the show yet. Apparently they except they got the picture on it. Yeah. Don't sleep every time they did it before, and yeah, every day they're like sleep.
No. It can't be.
No, I never cheated on that math test in 7th grade.
Boys, wake up. What are you doing? You're sleeping.
No. It isn't true. I'm somehow friends with a bunch of impromptu demigods that baffles the very face of science, even though I've dedicated my entire adolescence to studying magic, which is the exact opposite of science! No!
Not again. If you with keyframe and they say a nightmare. Again.
Twilight! The fun for Camp Everfree leaves at 10 minutes! Twilight! You got late! You have overslept for your work! Yes, Mom!
No, I can't believe I overslept!
Well, congrats, Twilight. You woke up in an anime. You might not want to forget your bread on the way to the bus stop.
Me neither. That's not like you.
I don't know like it. And even, like, you know, the Crystal Empire, he just slept, and it is, like, overslapping.
Question. Where are Twilight's parents? Because I'm pretty sure they didn't authorize her friends barging into her room this early in the morning.
That's a good question. But, unfortunately, I don't know where they go. I think he's just like an airport crashing and then they're both dead. You're welcome!
Excuse us, 6 friends of your daughter who saved the world 3 times using crazy magic that nobody ever questions coming through!
Don't you have a super annoying alarm clock that goes
But that's the alarm. This is the alarm for now, but... This is when it's so funny alarms I can tell. It's like, you can use the return as like an alarm, or your phone.
Excuses. You probably got so annoyed with your alarm clock you just ended up covering with your pillow for a good night's sleep.
That's one super efficient pillow.
It's inside the pillow. Again.
See, what I tell you.
What I think is interesting is how the movie cleverly hints that it's actually a dream sequence. And how, you know, Pinky is kind of like the voice in your head that tells what you honestly want to say. And because of that, you know, she is the one who admits that Twilight hates her alarm clock.
Yeah.
Gonna be out in the woods? When's she gonna need that?
We don't need to dress her like that before.
If we were going to the moon, I'd insist she packed an evening gown.
Equestria Girls 5, we're going to space.
Dante Equestria Girls and the new series of being in space. Space, a great thing today. Wait a minute! No, I forgot the rest of the song. Forget it. Bah! Again, the Rainbow Dash thing. Oh, no!
God, Sideway's been holding out on us! You see that? You see that right there? Twi-OTP confirmed! I mean, that's unbelievable! There's your definitive proof that aside from cadence and rarity, absolutely no girl on this show wants the dick!
Sorry about that. Continue.
You need to calm down a second, Vespio. The only way we can tell, like, yeah, it is confirmed of Twi-Dash, confirmed of the life, love.
What? In front of the camera? No, this is a kids' movie. Stop! Do something!
It's just something like, no, no, actually, it's not. We're in a kids' movie. Not in the kids' movie. What did you tell him to do? Please get away. Like censoring. Like he said, is like he was a bit panic.
I live again.
Oh, thank goodness, a demonic entity. Whew.
Except for that part.
And I was scared for a moment something bad would happen.
Digitize yourself again.
God. Did they just die?
I never thought I'd find a use for this, but...
Delete!
He said, like, I never seen that movie where it is like, delete it! It was like someone who, why not just like panic like, Hayden, delete it! Oh, okay. And then this is a bit of a little problem there. And why is he died? No, that's definitely not to die, to digitize! You know, like the technology to try on before.
Oh, she's deleting the DHX assets! No!
Dun dun dun!
I am in control of your mind! Could I get a hug?
Bad touch.
Did he say bad touch? Oh, I get it. He just like grab it and then like boosh and right to free your back.
See, Twilight, I told you, this is why you always take the blue pill.
Like everyone else, you were born into bondage. Born into a prison that you cannot smell or taste or touch. A prison for your mind.
Twilight.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a bit like, is it a blue pill or something like a lot of people does, like, all of them. You know, it could be the little inclusion before.
Wake up!
I have a feeling this is some kind of metaphor for, teenage...
Except for the picture, look at the Twilight's face. Yeah, it's in the... Yeah, that thing right up top, when I pointed at it, my thing is just... out of my way. Okay, I'm gonna have to add this one, all dragging down, and like this. And you see... This is the pointing. This is what I pointing. This is what the picture phrase gotta go for. Yeah. Now let's continue alone.
It's anxiety or something?
Stop!
Wait.
What else am I talking? I thought everything got reset after the fabric of the universe has fixed itself.
Okay then. Those first couple of minutes are actually a pretty good hook.
You know, actually this is like the first minute of hook. And yeah, that's right, Dr. Wolf, you exactly got it correct.
I hope the rest of the movie is this interesting.
We are gonna have so much fun! We're gonna roast marshmallows and eat marshmallows and sleep on marshmallow pillows!
Wait, do you have a marshmallow pillows on it? An inclusion of Kmart. And also, don't forget, the cheeseburger pillow, too.
Oh, didn't think Pinky actually shipped herself with rarity.
You're going to do what to me?
Whose voice is not... Wait a minute, this wasn't Vespio doing it, isn't it? He's hugging the pillow of a marshmallow. Except a pile of like 100 marshmallows.
Oh. Okay, never mind.
I mean, yeah, who keeps food laying around just like completely out of nowhere, am I right? I mean, that's just silly, man. Like, who'd even come up with something like that?
Okay, just to point it out once again why this high school setting is still a little bit weird. Sunset Simmer eggs. A lot more mature, which, once again, I mean, this might be her literal age, even pony years, as she's only like 16, 17, whatever. But she is like, she has the empathy, she is like, she wants to say something. So, obviously, the average pony, like Sunset Shimmer, is a lot further in the development when they reach this age. So, anyway, yeah. We're in for a high school movie, so let's do this.
You know, I could say that high school movie. That's great. That's a good reference.
We were your age. We made some of our favorite memories in these woods.
Except when Luna said it, we know about the memory of the woods.
And with that one line, all the clop artists went crazy.
And we're sure you will too.
That's probably more lines than Luna's ever gotten the entire past two seasons.
Okay, since when did principals chaperone field trips instead of their teachers? Actually, now that I think about it, where's Cheerily been since the first movie?
Oh, he stayed in the school for a while, in the library. Don't remember the one with the question in the first movie. Don't remember if because of that Cheerily stuck in the library, you forgot the one thing. Who forgot bring Cheerily? No one even freaking talk. Free
you know, aside
talk.
Aside from Life is a Runway.
Who's excited for Camp Everfree?
Everybody's crowding like, yeah, we're going to camping, except Final is like listening.
Jesus, these aren't millennials. These are Xers. These are Gen Xers right here, because millennials would not be excited to camp.
Hey, I see you trying to hijack my little bonbon.
The hat is looks like Bon. That bonbon like wearing your hat too? Oh my god, in cartoon anime.
I see that.
Oh dear! Oh god, it's a deer! You know, this is gonna be a Disney up in a Bambi, you know?
Deers! Deers, 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 deers! My people are being represented finally!
Wait. Dude. This song sounds kind of familiar, doesn't it? I've heard this before, let me recall the lyrics.
Oh yes, now I remember.
What is it?
We travel the road of generations, joined by a common bond.
What that song is, I don't even remember. Let's continue to hear what he said.
We sing our song across the Pony Nation, from Equestria and beyond. That's a song, right?
That's like a quiz. I don't know which song is it. I don't know. I don't know what that song is. Can you get the comment below too? I don't know what that is. It's like a quiz music, like, what's that sound? I don't know. Australian game have a music on the TV commercial.
Wouldn't it be funny if the bus, when it passed by the orange juice truck, AJ just gave that bus like...
Yeah, exactly. That's a good point.
I'm not gonna lie. This song definitely sets the mood. You can't help but, you know, clap along to it. It's not as good as Rainbow Rocks, but, you know, still it's pretty good.
Opening song has some nice guitar, and it feels very much like a campfire song to better fit the environment.
Yeah, exactly. He said a guitar and then the fire set.
Just not that into the lyrics.
Well, someone forgot to put in the lyrics.
Did you guys ever realize that since this Ghost music video became so popular, there is a lot of bouncing whenever music is playing?
Wait, hold a pause. Look, do you see that? Look at this! Do you see that? Those eyes! It isn't like Sakura's eyes. Do you mean Sakura's is evil? Oh my god. And I hope so for the next series of the season 5. Also, the next movie. Next movie, Sakura's Return of the Vengeance. Yes, for the question girls.
And I mean, look at it. The bus is doing it as well. It's a weird thing.
He bounced up and down.
I love the opening song for the movie. It actually reminds me a lot of the band Fun. And if you listen close, you actually can tell it's in the same key as Some Nights.
Not as impressive with the visuals for the opening credits. I mean, previous films had far more going on, far more flair and creativity. Especially Rainbow Rocks. Yeah, I gotta go watch that again.
Okay, yeah, you exactly. I'm gonna be brutally honest here. Out of all the intro sequences of these movies, this has got to be the laziest. I mean, come on. It's so painfully obvious that this is just Apples to the Core 2.0.
Yep, he's
if you want a proper Equestria Girls Camp movie intro theme, then do it right.
There were six girls who made a friend that sounds
like oh, no.
S-U-N-S-E-T. S-U-N-S-E-T. S-U-N-S-E-T.
Shimmer was her last name.
And then those girls all went to camp and turned it upside down. Oh. S-U-N-S-E-T.
S-U-N-S-E-T.
S-U-N-S-E-T. And Shimmer was her last name.
And this song... Okay, I think Festival just made a song. This reference gonna... This pronouncing will be put in Nickelodeon's or Cartoon Network for this, and apparently we get to put that thing on Cartoon Network or Nickelodeons for this one on Nick.
Okay,
I really love that song. Maybe that was great. I felt like, you know, beats. Squirrel! Oh, no! What did I just wrong? Wait, hold on. I'll be right back. Yeah, I think I'll fix it right now. Sorry about that. That was accidentally hit the bar problem, and then, yeah, I fix it up now. Okay, we're all good to go. Let's go.
More specifically, so I can chase him.
Here we have Spike, playing the role of Dog, Academy Award winning
I'm just after some R&R. The past year has all been a bit too much for my taste.
How much larger do you have? Like, a lot of them?
Well, what do you know? Rarity is actually packing light for once.
Yes!
I bet that one of those bags has Princess Vespa's industrial-sized hairdryer.
Da-da.
Three evil sirens who tried to hypnotize everybody with their singing.
Again.
One ridiculously competitive rival school, and two demon friends.
Wow, Pinkie Pie not knowing how to read a room.
Yeah.
Nothing new there.
Yeah, not like we haven't exhausted this plot point before. Hey, let's keep reminding you that, you know, you
always kill everyone. Should I grab her away from him?
Technically, you already did.
Okay.
Will we ever get rid of this joke?
Yes.
You'll get used to it.
We're gonna stick pens in their eye sockets.
Hey, kids. Feeling bored by this movie already?
Yes. Yes.
And I might got the game for you. It's called... Count the Questionable Meme Faces.
Ooh, what does this do, Mr. Vespio?
Whenever you see a single frame of this picture that seems the slightest bit odd for a kid's movie, good for you! Because Derpy Boar will probably already beat you to it.
Well, he's a Derpy Portal, and you know, the website link I have liked to see the Derpy Portal. Except the one we have people had like to see the all a bunch of not allowed for like under 18. That's a lot of problem, kids. Do not do with the Derpy Poo. Only you can tell. Sorry, kids, you're not allowed on Dupiku because you need to turn 18 for now. Yeah, because only age is like 18 or more. Like, it's like rated or something.
But it's fun to count anyway. Then, once the film is done, tally your count, and then you question why your mind is as far down in the gutter as mine is.
Even the D-Nerd, you can say it again.
Surely the shippers are already going mad with our first one.
That's means. What does the means mean?
Oh, don't forget that Midnight Sparkle frame from earlier!
What did he done? He's like, he jumped and like glitched and like up and down, he's like glitching. He's like, I wanna shake your ass right here.
We still got a lot of movie to get through, folks, so keep them eyes peeled and good luck!
And also, only you could get a prize of an edition. Also, there would be the Friendship Games, Rainbow Rock, and the original Question Girls on the Me site. Unduplicated.
Enterlot High has become a regular magic magnet. Gonna be nice getting away to a place where we don't have to work.
Tracy talked to Octavia? Yes, please, you had to talk to there.
About that kind of stuff.
Oh my goodness!
Are we in the kitchen?
Applejack's favorite dish! Slow roasted irony! Oh, it's gonna taste so good by the second act!
Don't eat it, dude.
And you're you, and we don't know each other very well.
Wow, that sucks for you, Flash.
Now go the way. yeah, I'd have that reaction too. Your waifu is an interdimensional pony princess and or gay. Get over it.
The thirst is so real.
Right. I guess I'll see you around.
Again.
And Flash gets friend-zoned.
Da da da.
Yeah. Didn't see that coming.
Isn't it weird I kind of feel sorry for Flash?
Poor fellow. I mean, at this point, I kind of start feeling bad for him. I mean,
apparently it was bad.
It's like falling for one twin and then meeting the other one who is kind of similar but not. Okay, you see. Still are very superficial if you just go by this. Huh. Maybe I don't feel bad for him after all.
Hi everyone! Welcome to Camp Everfree! I'm Gloriosa Daisy, your camp director!
Hello, everybody. I'm your camp director. Apparently, this is named by Paul Heyman. That's not WWE. The other one we had to forgot him. Had to made it a name on the campsite.
Think of me as your friendly camp and need your guide.
A guide. Apparently, he does.
Gloriosa. What do you suppose she's hiding?
Ah, Imperata Gloriosa, back from the Friendship Road, I see.
Da, da, da.
What a lovely necklace you have. Is that from the Foreshadowing Collection?
And this is yes. My brother, Timber Spruce.
Okay.
And this is my brother. Goddamn.
So.
Goddamn's the way to name him.
Don't work the same way in this universe.
Think of me as that awesome guy. Who should always be invited to fun things?
So before we hand out our tent assignments, we'd like to hear from all of you.
Final is just like, and then he's just like, what do you do? And then Derby just like, Final, get off the helmet and listen something.
You're free to do whatever you like here.
Wow, thanks for making this even harder to keep this PG, guys.
Did you really just say this to a bunch of teenagers?
If I wish I had to. Say rock climbing?
Of course! Tetherball! Naturally!
I want to stay inside and play video games.
Ooh, I want to play video games. And let's play the game! Ha ha ha! Oh, I got a Pokemon Sun Moon for now, but I got something to a legendary Pokemon I can catch more! I really love legendary! Yeah, like he said, if he wants her animated.
Pokemon Go! Netflix and chill! A fight club!
What about murder?
Oh my god, I saw something I didn't miss the petrified. How to get a mask for Rey Mysterio and then there's a fake knife. It's to say, what about murder? And he forgot about the murder way, like Jetson Thuwil from the Boris, and instead of the horror movie.
Arts and crafts! My mom needs new pot holders.
Oh my god, Snowflake. He hadn't done notice anymore!
Okay. Bulk, you've gone from funny to downright adorable at this point.
I just realized Bulk has an earring.
Yeah.
Oh, he's the best character.
Well, I do make a mean sugar cookie.
I'm still watching a family-friendly movie, right?
Oh, this is a sugar cookie. He's like, your grandma's gonna start it again.
A fashion show where I just...
Eyes. Hey! Oops, the microphone. Sorry, my microphone. I didn't mean that way. I mean, we are not in a fashion show. We're in the goddamn cabin.
Oh well, Rarity likes fashion. I didn't know that.
How long are you going to stay there? I mean, designing dresses for all your friends and putting up a fashion show within 1 week? While doing
like he said.
At a camp?
I'm taking requests the rest of the time you're here, so if there's anything you'd like to do,
He haven't do anything, he just started. He haven't do-
Oh, come on, guys, he hasn't even done anything to make us hate him yet.
For 1 second.
Timber? Why? You giving Twilight them looks?
He's like, he's smiling.
Yes, really. Well, I just thought. Then you thought wrong.
The wrong is just saying, Hayden, why are you guys just thought wrong? Someone had not noticed my channel. No one even know before yet.
Anyone else picking up on a little tension between Gloriosa and her brother?
Yes.
I like to whisper out of the side of my mouth, too.
I really do whisper, and even I talking to myself once.
Gazebo was a gift from last year's group.
Jeez, okay. We never made a gazebo when I went to summer camp. You know what I ended up making? A freaking birdhouse.
Even though some people thought it was a little impractical since a sundial can't be used at night.
Luna becoming into a nightmare moon this time. Again, once again, if it's a nightmare moon.
Pause. Let's talk about Luna's outfit for a second. Boy, why is Luna out here dressing like a discount Pokemon trainer?
Yeah, exactly. Don't he become a Pokemon trainer? I wonder if he'd become a Pokemon trainer.
You are not 10. You are way too old to be wearing those young-ass shorts. And don't even get me started on those kicks. What are those?
Just waddles! Those are the boots for work, and socks are for work. Even, you know, the warehouse or any food stuff shop, factory, or a builder's place.
Because your name is Luna doesn't mean you gotta be wearing moon shoes.
Why is vinyl?
Moon shoes.
Hands like this, that wouldn't be vinyl. She's out of character. 0 out of 10. Worst movie ever.
Ah.
Yay! I'm in the Emerald
Tent. I love Emerald because of Pokemon version.
Ooh, me too.
Well, I'll be damned. Ship confirmed.
Ugh. Worst ship ever.
Pink Rev. Pink Red. Pinky Ray.
If this would be board game night, Tim and I would have a little chat about shuffling the deck properly.
Except that.
What?
I call the Peridot Tent! I call the Peridot Tent!
Flutter Scratch.
Flutter Scratch?
Vinyl.
Okay, just like he say Final Scratch, doesn't mean he sound like something with that cutie mark is different when a newborn came out and doesn't know how to use wobs and shide.
That'll never catch on.
They can be pink, purple, yellow.
Except for blue.
Yeah, but they're mostly blue. That's why they're named after the Latin word spherus.
I love blue because it's my favorite color. Even my color is blue and my twin brother color is red. Why is that? Because I have a team on it somehow.
That means blue.
But did you know that sapphires are just rubies without chromium?
Oh, I see. Now I'm getting around that in the jewelry place. Now I can tell sapphires can tell what is a crypto, and even greater in this part.
Whoa, 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 whoa,
whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa. Are you actually having a conversation to establish similarities and chemistry?
Wow, now 5 seconds of shared screen time and they already have better chemistry than Flashlight.
Yeah.
Push your girl's character.
Male species.
Personality.
What is with Hasbro and the weird finger touching?
You know, it's like it's something to touch. It's like... I got it. It's like it's gonna be the finger touch simulator. Like... You can do it, guys. You can make a finger simulator touch.
I accidentally touched fingers with the cashier when he handed me my receipts, and now I'm pregnant!
But that sapphire tent is the best one.
No. Why is that?
Because you're in it.
The face is like... Look at his face. He's at... What? I don't care. I don't really care. Care anymore? Well, I probably like get the Swedish of this video and get like this reference by Wii U Thick Reveal.
Damn, his eyebrows are on fleek.
Yes.
You know what? On second thought, guys, go ahead.
Boo.
Be your heart's content.
The reason Flash had to be pushed aside was so this timber guy
would step in. Oh my god.
Let's wait and see what sort of impression this one leaves.
I like this guy. Good addition.
I bet you say that to all the campers.
And it'd have a bit smart too.
Not true. You're in the ruby tent? Ha! That's the worst one!
Yes! Except not for you, dude. I'm talking about my twin. Yes! Ha! We don't like red because reds suck because he don't want to be. He's because he's like an evil or something.
Fired!
Let me know if you need anything!
The mouth wide like, you need an ending! It's like sound like the mouth go wider. But he didn't say like, you didn't go through in the mouth like that. That before. Philly Rich. Again.
You know, I just say something you need to know. How you feel fine, you need to stop the fashion ways. Did you say something you need to be more richable? I want to take down the camp.
Filthy Rich is in this movie? And the background music suggests he's supposed to be the bad guy here?
Oh, filthy rich. Thanks, Celestia, you're here. Please save us from this summer romance. Come on, pave this place and put...
This guy's never felt that way.
Something useful.
What, they couldn't get Diamond Tiara to fill that role this time around?
Oh yeah, where's Diamond Tiara anyways?
Well, at any rate, I'm hoping this is just a fake out.
No, no. This is not Filthy Rich. Filthy Rich in the show was a very welcome change.
I guess he's it.
Oh, rich and evil guy singing. No, he was a sympathetic guy, even so he had money. This here is a typical rich businessman douchebag cliche. Seriously. Okay, I...
I don't even know exactly why, but I need some drink of water. I'll be right back. This is like a different note.
Get it. It's a spin-off franchise, but stop slanderizing the already established characters. If you really need to go for this super unlikable, overused cliche of the slimy, unlikable rich guy, please invent a new character and don't ruin an existing one.
He likes to check on his old stomping grounds every now and again.
Because
again, we're going to check in money for the spar.
He's going to stomp all over the ground for a mini mall or something.
I'm all for learning safety rules, but I do hope I can get started on my designs for the camp fashion show sooner rather than later.
Them hips, though.
Just as long as you don't... That song had just confirmed exactly the same before that trailer for Rainbow Rocks.
Don't put me in one of your fancy pants outfits. You're gonna, aren't you? No.
Movie's pretty good so far, but even if it ends up sucking, that 36 seconds of Rara Jack was totally worth it.
Didn't mean that scary, like a ghost story.
Oh my god, I haven't seen Geisha there for 3 months!
Her brother is pretty cute though, huh?
Except that the face is like, what are you talking about? I don't think it's insane anything.
Stop shipping, Sunset.
He's okay. Ooh, now look who's trying to hide something.
Again. And this face is like, just go to the date. Just do it, Twilight, just do it.
I transferred here, everyone from CHS has been really nice and accepting.
Sorry, I had just a bit sneezing today.
Especially considering what happened at the friendship games.
That wasn't your fault. Principal Cinch is the one who encouraged you to try and use all that magic to win the games for Crystal Prep.
That's the one. And also, what happened in the pony version, what Principal Cinch go grow through the mirror again, and then he become Queen Cinch, the dark ruler of the world of the Ponyville, and he tried to conquer all the Equestria came by. And yeah, that's exactly the same one he gonna do. He's gonna plan and get and cross over and take over the world and take over by command by the guards.
Exposition, and more exposition from both Twilight and Sunset.
And if there's any group that's gonna forgive you for something that happened in the past, trust me, it's this one.
Yeah, exactly. Trust this one is in the camp.
Well, after we'd neuralized everyone's minds and deleted any and all photographic evidence from their phones. But yeah, they're totally forgiving.
I just want to put on some sunscreen.
Sunscreen, Shanna! Yeah, it's just a bit of reference in this one.
But you're yellow. Why would you need to put on sunscreen? How does skin pigment work in this universe exactly?
Turn orange for that? Yeah. It would turn tan and turn orange.
Found it!
The magic came by life.
Say what?
I'm gonna put some sunglasses on the top and it's easy.
Dear Twilight Sparkle, for violating the no magic clause, you are hereby expelled from Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry.
Are you kidding? This is great! I mean, we've all ponied up before.
Again, not this time.
No!
Use the force, Sunset.
Use the force! Hurry up, Sunset Shimmer! Use the force and you need to know! Voice of Yoda.
You're just gonna have to pick it up.
Aww.
Aww, but that requires effort!
Aquaria is not in the fire, Mr. Voice!
Well, well, Sunset, the important thing is that you tried. You failed, but you tried.
You failed.
Sunset feels when she can actually remember growing up as a unicorn, using magic to get whatever she needs. And then, right after Twilight shows that magic is creeping back into their lives, Sunset still can't pull it off herself. I mean, what does that do to a person?
Pony. I feel so bad for her. I mean, she used to be a unicorn, and not just any unicorn, but a really talented one who was using her magic a lot, and now she is stuck without anything, and for those who don't know, there was actually a song, or a second half of a song in the last movie, which was ended up on the cutting floor, where she was actually missing her magic, and a little bit now a callback to this, like...
Oh my god, Danny, what the hell are you doing here? What are you doing? You took it for the recording! Except for you, Danny, you're... When did he say Ruby? Red suck! You suck, you're red team! No. You're the one who just made the record. You messed this up! Then he just get through the door and then he just grabbed my bag. And he wants to go to something. I don't care. Sorry, guys. This is a bit annoying by him. I had to make sure just get a label and a crop and just stay here a bit. Or just stick with it. Also, Danny came in, I had to call Ruby because he's red. I had to call him Suck. Because he's red. He's a red team member. Not yet anyone who guys on the red team bases, but just Danny, because he just become red.
Huh. So, apparently it's not only Twilight having a little bit of residual magic over from the events of the last movie, but develop some kind of new skill? In this world, which did not have magic before all those Equestria Girl shenanigans, what kind of explanation do they have this time? How miles away from the school there's again magic?
Because if there is anything I can do to make this week the best week ever, you just let me know.
The best way to let me know.
I've got this.
This is gonna be suck, this one. There's gonna be counts.
I'm the villain!
People that chipper make me nervous.
Yep.
I feel you, Sunset.
I guess not all people.
Shit! Hold on. Wait, strike in. Mees! There he is. He hug and he's just like.
Fire!
Well, there is the exception to every rule. Sketchy.
The birds that land on your finger.
I think that only happens to you.
Tweet, tweet.
And Disney princesses.
Disney princess that confirmed by Snow White.
Okay, can we just replace all Fluttershy's dialogue about the birds with Android 16 from Dragon Ball Z Abridged?
Really?
Wiring hobbies.
Oh.
Whoa.
Don't.
I know I'm charming, but you don't have to fall for me.
What else?
Boo! Put effort into your flirting!
Ow! Ow!
This is going to be a thing throughout the movie, isn't it?
Yeah.
Score two for the Timinator.
So because he's technically in a love triangle and he's the one who actually has chemistry with the girl, it probably means he's evil.
Guess I can't get too jealous, right?
Yeah, except for no to help.
You are asking your ex-girlfriend.
So you're saying I just need to get over her?
Kinda, yeah.
Exactly, she said.
Shut down.
Jesus, they're like just assassinating the ship right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, a moment of silence for the death of a ship that drove the fandom crazy.
Yeah, that does not understand like the trumpet sound like that before. Sorry.
Alright, that was fun. Who wants s'mores?
Yay.
That was good dialogue between two former mates. That's probably nothing special.
He had an actual human conversation with another human being! My flash issues! They evaporated! I can enjoy these movies again!
Yay!
This is a safety hazard. I suggest we close down the dock for the remainder of the camp.
Nay!
Oh my god! What is this? Are there being responsible adults? That's crazy. That would have really helped in the friendship games when crazy magical bullshit happened and then you, you know, didn't stop the race.
If you ask me, this whole dock needs to go.
He kicked it in a log and like, we don't need that shit.
Building a new one could be our camp gift.
Manual labor, it's the fun thing to do.
Does AJ understand the logistics of building a dock? You have to swim underwater.
I hear what you're saying, Timber, but we're Canterlot Wonder Colts.
Yeah, like he said.
We've got a reputation to uphold.
No. Oh, my head! My sunglasses. I need to something. My brain's about to burn. Oh god, my brain. Oh, please don't say any more. We've done enough. We've done enough. It's all, my brain's hurting.
Oh no, she said the R word. That can only mean...
boxes of food so you can feed the ducks and fishies.
Fluttershy, are you like five? Why do you say fishies?
And we'll make an absolutely perfect runway for my cat fashion show!
Can I make a shut up rarity counter, please?
I wish I could have been in words and like, rarity, we're not in the fashion show in there. We're in the camp on!
Okay. For the sake of my own mental sanity, I shall now be replacing every time Rarity says fashion show with human sacrifice.
Can we call camping?
Absolutely perfect runway for my cat.
Human sacrifice.
Finally.
You should see my macaroni art. I'm like the Picasso of noodles.
Oh,
big giggling.
God, it's like Flash Sentry was actually trying, yet it's somehow worse.
I just watched a boy try to woo a girl.
Why don't you just playful?
Girl with macaroni art.
Bring a macaroni, you get an awesome pacamoni.
That's when she looked down.
Oh my god.
Realized she was wearing purple socks with a burgundy dress.
I can see Pinkie Pie's having marshmallow. Like, wow, that's a lot of them. Pinkie, you don't need that much. It made like a marshmallow ice cream ball right to the stick. And Trixie in there too. Yay, Trixie sitting on it, and there's Trixie socks. Even Trixie shoes. And, yeah. Let's see in there. It wasn't that.
Rarity, purple with burgundy? What's next, green and brown?
And I bet another way that this happened, don't say it a word, Fespio.
Anyone else have a spooky story?
I am! You forgot me! And someone you need to know! My name is Badundo! I don't know if I got this boy's name. But you need to know! You forgot something to demand the fire! Yes, of course! You need to find a way to get to defeat me!
How about the tale of the rabid Starlight haters?
No.
Oh shit, is Will in this react video?
Yeah, you just said it.
Strike one, Sketchy.
Is that a fly swap for when he's holding it? It's not a bug or something. How long did that count?
Ooh, pick me, I have a scary story. Okay, this one starts at a summer camp, just like this. It was called Camp Crystal Lake.
But I'm warning you.
This dude and his Sotsky-ass eyebrows.
You might as well hug a friend now.
And hug a friend now? Yes, that's a great idea.
That's how scary it is.
Oh dear.
Many years ago, my great-grandparents came to this forest.
Okay, I only realize at this point, but there's something really off with this family. They have normal skin colors.
They screamed and ran outside, only to see a giant creature rising from the earth.
Now you belong to me. You belong to me.
Wait, you grateful flower. I am the ever free.
Oh, there is another equestrian monster living in the forest? But
yes.
That doesn't explain why Twilight and Sunset have no
power. It was a monster, you know. And that's never happened.
Oh god, foreshadowing. Foreshadowing everywhere.
I wasn't scared. You're ridiculous. Excuse me, I need to go change.
Why'd you come?
Wait, did you poop yourself?
The bushes.
I took the scenic route because the forest is beautiful at night.
She's the villain! She's the villain! That's her right there! She's the villain! Also,
villain.
You have extra toothbrushes? I forgot mine.
Yeah, could be worse. They could be Ma Hoofield's teeth.
Of course! I got this!
I'm gonna get that gown. Please. No, no one has to put that counts on the video. No counts. Sorry.
Should I even bother putting up a counter every time she says, I got this?
Again, the counts.
You know it's only gonna go up, people!
Snip, snails. Guys, I know she's a cute girl who's gonna turn into a paranormal monstrosity, and she's probably looking for minions, but Sunset is standing right there.
Yeah, like... guys. Like he said.
Some creature that got booted from Equestria and ended up in this world.
That's what I said!
Let us see.
More than our fair share of those. At the fall formal, our musical showcase, the friendship game. Well, I mean, you know, everything turned out all right, of course.
Rarity, you sucked this one.
Good job, Rarity. Good job.
Oh, you know, no offense, am I right? Seriously, this is turning into the whole I'm not blank, but, like, seriously, guys, come on.
I'm gonna turn in.
Turn into what exactly, Miss Sparkle? Some kind of magical demon?
Maybe lay off bringing up what happened at the friendship games. I think she's still pretty sensitive about it.
Well, they did that with you, like, all the time, Sunset.
Scary.
These are horrible people.
What also shows what a strong personality Sunset has, because now we see a direct contrast how somebody else goes through similar things she went through in the second movie, and how Twilight handles this completely differently.
Ah!
This bitch is great, and it's just like, wait, what happened? What happened? Where we got an ninja new? This is like Nagi.
Sunset's out here looking like Mr. Magoo.
Beware, evil! I am the master of sleep, foo!
If you could learn to control it,
but that's just it. I'll never be able to control it.
So I shall go on pretending like my magic doesn't exist, because that strategy is working.
You don't deal with this!
Oh, hey, Trixie's in this. I completely forgot.
Spirit, show yourself. The great and powerful Trixie commands it.
Not exactly the real magician. The spirit. As you grant your wish.
My thoughts exactly, Pinky. My thoughts exactly.
That was pretty good, but it's no peanut butter crackers.
Aw, oh, peanut butter sandwich is great.
I was the one to have a reaction like this. And second... Yeah, our one sentence cameo from Trixie for the movie. The fanboys are pleased. Yeah.
That was in there like four movies and white. And here's the fact: Trixie's in there like four movies in a row. He's been there already. Even the snapshot. Even he taking the destroying it.
The Everbreed needs a runway.
Dock.
The dock.
Why do they do this to you, Rarity? You're supposed to be concerned. A normal person would be concerned that the dock they just spent, like, a day or a week or however long this took to be destroyed. But no, you just care about the fashion show.
Like he said, thank you. Thank you very much, Reason. Raisin. I wish I had to call Raisin. Raisin or just because, like, a scooter fan.
This is supposed to be my favorite character.
Man, you remember when Rarity was actually funny?
This movie's pretty generous with the Rarajack moments. I appreciate that.
If I can stay with the light, I know I'll be free. And I can start to be whole, I can start to be me. And I know
okay, honestly, I'm having goosebumps right now.
Evanescence, would be proud, Twilight.
Twilight's first song has some lovely piano in the background. I suppose it's interesting to see her going through the struggle of wondering whether she might be the one causing harm to others. But I'm still not really feeling the lyrics.
It happened.
That was amazing! That's the kind of music I like to hear! I mean, wow! That was almost Broadway ballad levels of deep and emotional. No lie, this legitimately gave me goosebumps. You know, if that's the kind of music we get to experience throughout this film, I'm in. Consider me hyped.
thank you. After a whole season of bad or poorly placed songs, it's nice to see one that's actually good.
To be honest, this song didn't tell us anything.
My finger's hurting.
But, oh,
so I tried to play it.
God, send it a shiver down my spine. Woo, I love it.
You know, that was a nice song and everything, but realistically, Twilight, they've already seen The Midnight in You, so how bad could the second time be?
So many squirrels.
And is dreaming about squirrels.
Spike!
Squirrel!
I really wanted to hang out at the mall. I've never told that to anyone. You must be special.
Hey, Brush.
You never told anyone that you wanted
He's
to
gonna
go to the mall
guess at this one, did he?
Okay.
How long has that been in there?
Not long. Just the whole time we were talking.
What?
Okay. First, the cheesy flirty one-liners, and now the teasing. He is like me!
That's true. I think it's a good question, NY. It was just like you. You're worried of teasing, and even people does. How are you closing that?
Make sure my sister doesn't need anything. See you later.
Bye.
This
little happy faces, like
in the first movie, and this kind of chemistry, the kind of interaction,
the second
not just looking at each other, blushing without any context.
Yes, like exactly said, right?
You called me out for it on the first movie. There, this is what I wanted to see, and what I'm getting now, kind of.
Okay. Yeah. His lines are cringeworthy, but. They're actually talking and connecting on some level. He has a role in the story that is aside from just being a romantic interest, and he has a relationship with another character that isn't Twilight. I'm okay with this.
Like, yeah, exactly.
Rarity, you can trust that Applejack will spot you.
Yes. Don't you make that sketchy. Don't make this second time sketchy. I'm just gonna have to live life, laddie.
Well, you have to wait a little longer.
That's too easy.
Might help if you weren't climbing in heels!
I've got this!
I got this, and every time this is like, it's annoying if they say, I got this. But do you always say it about this, or twice again, or a third time?
No, every time Gloriosa says, I got this, I'm inclined to compare her to George Lopez.
I got this!
It seems like she dies inside every time she says, I got this. I got this! I got this! I got this!
Yeah.
We were just decorating cookies and
that was all! You need more sprinkles and you need more sprinkles!
You get sprinkles! You get sprinkles! Everyone gets sprinkles!
Yay!
How dare you reference Oprah.
Now I want to see what Sapphire Shores looks like in this universe. If she is, in reality, the Oprah of Crusher Girls.
Yo.
Toss sprinkles to Fluttershy when all of a sudden they glowed pink and exploded!
Pinky has bombs! Pinky has bombs!
Pinky.
She got grenades in it.
He can make explosions. Oh, this camp is doomed. Like, hard. I'm talking the new name needs to be Camp Crater.
Oh. Okay, why don't you lay off touching stuff for a while?
Why not? He forgot explosion?
What are you talking about, Sunset? It's not like I quite literally destroy everything I touch!
Hello, bird. What is your name? Toriyama. I would love to see your dinosaur. It does what?
Were you just talking to the birds?
Yes. What is owls? But the question is, are you talking to birds? But why the owls are different? Look at those eyes. This owl's like, they're angry. They're like the angry birds in this reference to everybody. Angry birds right in there. That's so, this is so hilarious.
Okay, pause for a minute.
Should I name the game?
The only one that wants to see an
angry owls.
Short based on these two owls? I mean, look at their eyebrows!
They're like angry birds, you know, like I said it. What should I name it? Angry owls!
So Rainbow Dash is like getting super speed, right?
Ow. Like Flash, you know?
Call it, yes!
Whoa.
No!
No, stop it. Stop trying to cartoon a movie.
What?
Alright?
What?
She'd be dead.
I don't care if this is a cartoon. If you run into a wall head first at speed, that's either a serious concussion or you're f***ing dead!
Dun dun dun! And Rainbow Dash died when he get bumped. When did you cheat something?
How are you alive, Rainbow?
Okay.
Because I'm great!
And now each of the main six have superpowers. It's Power Ponies all over again. It'll certainly make the eventual conflict more interesting, though.
Applejack, I was looking for you!
Oh god!
Applejack, I'm looking for you everywhere. Where are you been?
The foreshadowing's back.
And I'm all out of arrows.
And all the bronies just went crazy.
Pinkie Pie? What are you doing?
Making a marshmallow.
Says everyone in the fandom every time she's on screen.
Okay, who else was reminded of Tangled during the floating lantern scene?
Well, it doesn't fly anymore. Good job, Pinky.
Oh well, now I get to eat it!
Ew, that's gross, dude. Don't eat it in the ground. We're not in, like, how to eat worms in the ground. Don't eat it.
Wouldn't that be great if you could just eat your mistakes? Oh, God. I sound like a Jaden Smith tweet.
Just your hand. I could see things. I could understand why you were leaving.
I touched things like this. If you touch something like this, you've been the Ferret Defiler.
Whoa! Sunset just got the plot convenient Ferret's exposition magic.
Yes.
Magic. This is my new magic. This is incredible.
You know, Elizabeth, like,
Raven?
I still don't think it's a good idea for me to be near the rest of our friends right now.
You didn't need, like, the friends. You don't mean, like, we don't want friends?
Not until we know why this is happening. Understood.
Yes.
Best scene, right here. This is why Sunset is awesome.
What was that?
That's right. With the axe!
I think this is very appropriate.
The holding with the axe.
Two kids gone die tonight!
Yes.
Oh, come on!
Did you poop again? How did you get poop? Fairy dust?
What a twist!
Yeah, what a twist.
No, wait! They suspected him. Now we can't be evil.
Nobody wants to come here because it's home to some angry ancient nature spirit. It sure would help his cause.
Well, geez, Sunset, why don't you go grab Shaggy and Scooby and put him out of business?
Well, man, like, you need something, you need to find the food! Yeah, I need to find them food! But yeah, I don't have a voice of these two yet.
I'm rather hoping that this Gaia Everfree is not really the villain of the story. It'll be more of a misunderstanding between her and the main six.
You gonna give us a hand here, Rarity?
Rarity is like being lazy in the world, like a sloth.
I would love to, but I really need to get the stitching on this poncho done if it's going to make it into the camp.
Human sacrifice.
Oh my god, no, yeah, thank you, Salesburger. You gave me an interrupt a word.
That is, if Rainbow Dash would hurry up and bring me more wood.
I can't go any faster. I don't want to end up in the woods again.
Again?
Illusion? Switch jobs.
Somebody might want to call Professor X about this.
Professor X knows everything about this.
Here you go!
Oh, duck and cover!
Everyone in the gate, how? Grenade! And then another grenade! Quick, throw the grenade before it comes in! Hurry!
Pinky, no!
About to explode!
Okay.
Maybe not.
I would just like to point out that Pinkie Pie almost threw a nail bomb at her friends!
Apparently, if you throw a nail, it's an explosion and everyone about to die, like the end of the detonation of the world.
You are really testing my patience, Pinkie.
Do you think the nails would explode like the sprinkles?
That never happens!
Yes? Because this would have switched the movie from family-friendly magical stuff to R-rated
gory stuff?
Yes.
You know,
thank
I
you.
Have a spare pair of rubber gloves as well as a straitjacket in the closet if you want to borrow it.
Yeah, where did you get it?
No, I won't say how I got it!
Which is why we shouldn't pretend this isn't happening. Do you have them now too? It started last night when I touched people.
Hey!
Raising!
It's like I can feel what they're feeling.
Hey!
And see their memories.
Oh. Okay then.
The memories of your key. Yep. I can. I take off the glasses off. What are you doing?
Okay.
So Pinkie Pie is on LSD all.
What the hell is LSD?
All the time?
Nope. No, that was possibly Pyro or Smiley HD.
I could buy that.
Best nightmare vision ever.
That explains so much.
I will just play my original live reaction to the scene.
Wait, really? What?
Whoa.
Blind reacts camp. Oh, I see.
Sunset touches Pinky's forehead, and yeah, it got a good laugh out of me.
Hey, Dr. One, if you can if Sunset Shimmer touch your head, what do you feel like?
Although, Sunset, your line should be, that explains so much, and yet doesn't explain anything at all.
So you have magic, okay. And it's not that great.
Good, Dusty is not here.
A sentence that nobody has ever said ever.
Wow, they let her sing and they didn't cut it out of the movie.
Yay!
Good job.
Alright,
two things. One, I'm getting a lot of Van Perry vibes from this
I'm in my butt!
That's the last movie we had a villain song telling you to unleash the magic.
Whoops.
Now this one's totally
sorry.
I just find that funny in hindsight.
When Rarity's look in the face like, get a slash tag, get a room.
Okay, that was pretty awesome.
That song was alright.
Come on, Sunset, we used to date.
Ooh, when I just get a room, like, when I just like, there's Tumblr or Twitter or demon on Facebookers and everything. Why don't you just like hashtag get a room and there's MLP and then you just type on MLP on it at Question Girls.
I know that something's bothering you.
I have my doubts about this statement because she used to be not very open because she was always wearing her megalomaniac facade. So I am not too sure you really got to know her flesh.
Yeah. You know, you've changed a lot since we went out. You're so much nicer.
Excited and nicer? Wow, I think he fought that way.
Thanks. I'm glad you noticed.
I ship it?
Oh, so now that Twilight curved you, you want to get back with your ex again?
Yes.
I respect that.
Wow. This is literally the most depth we have ever gotten out of Flash. And Flash and Sunset possibly getting back together? I'm all for it.
Oh, okay, that's sweet. I think maybe we can work with this.
Yeah.
Steal my damn waifu.
He said, steal my waifu. Goddamn. Beep. Something. Should I code like beep?
Friends.
Sounds great. I gotta go.
Wow.
You
didn't
make it even into the friend zone.
Or not. Okay, so. A fandom hated Flash because he was perfect, but he didn't get with Twilight, and for the past few movies, he's kind of just gotten the short end of the stick. And now he's got nothing. He can't get with that Twilight, he can't get with this Twilight, he can't even get with Sunset. So what is the point in hating him anymore, guys? I feel sorry for him at this point. What are we supposed to do with Flash? Unless the next movie gives him something, he's basically irrelevant.
Well, apparently, you need to know how to get him alive to get another girlfriend part, right? Why not just there's like, another girlfriend who could be, like, someone who does, but not me, but apparently, who is a girl will be a new girlfriend. Could be Starlight Glimmer or something? Well, no, not exactly not. Why not Chili? He'd kick a rock like, fuck you, rock. if you
get
luck.
It, Flash. Just take what you can get.
I hate it when you walk into a cobweb. Oh, you just know the spider's up in the corner like, got ya!
And he looks like an evil Spider-Man. Except for Felon.
Okay, when they address it so directly, they will explain it, right? You have an idea, you have a plan, you know what you're doing there, right, Megan?
Nothing. It's all me.
It evil smile, it's all me. Yeah, it was a bit of a stupid smile if I try.
It's me, Sunset! It was me all along!
No.
I don't need to answer.
Why the phone?
Because I called it.
They're behind on your payments, Gloriosa.
Are you needing something you need for Gloriosa? It's time for your change artifact. You need a lot of money, but I have to buy something to the camp.
I own the land now.
You know, they own the land for me. I'm the only one I had to buy to get a new result of a great massage and the spa result.
No, I never really understood why every medium outside of FIM portrays Filthy Rich as a bad guy. I mean, in the show, at worst, he's just an oblivious parent. I'm not really seeing why they have to paint him as the evil businessman here.
The power...
Wait, so the source of her power were the Energems from Power Rangers Dino Charge? If this movie doesn't have a morphing sequence by the end of it, I'll be incredibly disappointed.
You know, they did exactly the same for the live react to the brain react, what I just said, too.
Well, it's like the Energems from Power Rangers Dino Charges.
Like I said, if I have a Power Ranger to Dino Charges, that's what I talk about, that's what I said. Yeah.
You were using magic all over the place. I had to tell them something to cover for you.
Let me see if I get this straight. So, Timber made up the story for campers so they'd have something to blame whenever anything weird was happening? Some sort of preemptive covering for Gloriosa because he knew beforehand that she'd inevitably make things worse? I don't get it.
This is all too much for you. You have to let it go.
You gotta let it go, this man. You need to let go everything in those memories. You don't know for sure.
No!
Again, why not just put a Jurassic Park at Fespa, why don't you just put Jurassic Park and like, what day? Eden already?
This is our camp, and it's being taken away! If this has to be our last week here, I'm going to use whatever it takes to make it count!
He'd be an evil for the last day, and it counts forever. And still, and Sunset Shimmer didn't do anything like, you done or something?
So let's see, we've had a world conqueror, mind f***ers, a scientist who tried to play God. Yeah, it's about time for a well-intentioned extremist.
So what exactly was Sunset doing during this entire vision? Because that was a long vision. Okay.
So how long was Sunset standing there? Is it like Raven where she just zones out when she's having a vision? Or does she process everything so fast it feels like time's slowing down for her?
Yeah, so she's been holding my arm while standing motionless for the past 2 minutes.
I feel better in my eyes.
Something...
It is so life.
No. Wow. This has been nearly 2.5 minutes of straight out plot summary exposition. This is...
Except for when he forgot Twilight dies and even Pinky.
The entire thing should have been like half a minute maximum. Quicker scenes. Keep it a little bit more abstract and not let those scenes play out in its entirety for this long.
Maybe you should stop using magic. Too much of it can be dangerous if you can't control it.
He said it right, and if we don't want to know, she said if he didn't listen.
Oh, I got this.
Again, and he's giving him to say, I got this, please don't get me a count already.
And I'm going to use it to save my camp.
And Gloriosa becomes ever more unbalanced because she doesn't have friends, apparently? Basically, this movie is telling me that any power you yield will eventually lead to corruption if you don't keep your friends as a priority in your life. I guess that works for the most part, as long as you don't think too hard about it.
That's right, girls. And if you are ever given the gift of extraordinary powers, ignore them or be constantly terrified of them. Or better yet, why don't you have a nice man take on all that burdensome power and responsibility you're clearly incompetent of utilizing? Because if you are confident and willing to use them, it means that you're a crazy psycho that will doom us all. Isn't that right, Jean Grey, Elsa, and April O'Neil?
Seriously, who just happened in a Ninja Turtle? Well, he's dead.
Donnie! Oh my gosh!
Don't get powerful women. This message is sponsored by the USC College. Oh, damn it! I didn't get the rest of them. I just get a little inch. I'll just give it a second if I need to read this message. Okay, this message is responsibility of the U.S. Intern and College. Dear people, who plan to respond to the totally opposite jokes with comics like What About, Hammond Lawson, Sailor Moon, Monica Magic, etc. You are being a smartass do not ruin the joke. And that's why you don't want to joke about what they reference about. For DLC.
Sorry, girls.
The eyes turn to EXE.
I know what I need to do.
So,
like Naga?
Crystals turn her into a demonic poison ivy?
Yeah,
yes.
I'm not really buying the whole she's a villain thing.
Which I read to make a demon art for this.
Okay, I know she's about to wreak havoc on the entire camp, but she's still kind of fine.
I am kind of missing the I will let you out later line here, so I hope she really doesn't forget about those two girls she just imprisoned in a cave.
I told you you'd like it.
I told you said it, and he wearing it? Hey, a good outfit.
It's alright, I guess.
Praise River Jack.
Oh, hail the prey of a god. Please attend another convern by River Jack. Please convert with the gods and spirits, and it all well.
That bird has very sharp hair.
What, that bird has very sharp hair? The 3D dimension? No, I don't want to do that. Yeah, screw you.
In the freaky tiki 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 camp, in the freaky tiki 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 camp.
But don't worry, I got them!
That is the-
Again and again and again and again. And I land on my nose. Good point for this part for myself.
The least intimidating catchphrase I can think of right now.
The round circles through the whole forest, made into a dome of forest. What?
Come on!
What are you pinky smiling? What is that?
Yep. Only Pinky would think this is fun somehow.
What? We haven't seen once. I didn't know Pinky can smile like, I enable, I want to be love with her. No, that was... That's evil. What is wrong with you, Pinky?
You know, the badassness of this scene kind of goes away when you realize that we've done this before.
Even equestrian games, too. Even, like, Rainbow Rocks or about Equestrian Girl when you get destructible for the first series. Why not the MLP series? They have Pinky Smile already to get into danger. What is that? What's going on?
Sorry, the flashback to something awful.
Now the magic is my salvation.
That is in my rotation.
That doesn't
protection.
Rhyme.
The songs are really rough, and I really like that song too. If I felt like the way.
Huh. Who knew Spitfire had such good pipes?
Okay, okay, seriously. You are best Poison Ivy knockoff.
Yes.
Oh, Gloriosa, you're
right. Poison Ivy's a greatest ideas.
And I do mean crazy.
I'm just gonna add that song to my favorites list.
Why do these kinds of things always happen to us?
It's called protagonist syndrome.
It's co-destructible.
Thankfully not very widespread, but some people suffer from it their entire life.
Because you're the main characters, and by story law, you're required to always face conflicts even when you don't want to.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy! This is gonna be so much fun! I only wish we had time to make superhero capes!
Being hero, like Robin.
Ooh, me too!
Meta Man, Express Elevator, Diner Guy, Snag on Takeoff, Splashdown, Sucked into a Vortex, Nook It!
This is a fluffy bird.
Twilight, we need your magic.
Twilight, you have to use your magic. I don't think I can live.
Again.
Hang on. I've got a quote for this. Size matters not. Like that, I wrote it myself.
I mean, I think Camp Everfree is absolutely delightful, but I just don't know that I'm quite ready to give up my weekly trips to the spa. To the spa.
She says, like, the spa, they said, the spa! And really, you did not learn what you just said to do, like, about that angry face. And look at and White's face, I paused it, and it was like, this is so scary, me! What are you gonna say, mama?
Trigger!
Oh my god! She just went from frightening to campy in one sentence.
That isn't your sister. It's someone who's been consumed by equestrian magic.
Oh, blame the magic. Oh, blame the magic.
No.
Remember, it's never your fault.
It's up to you. You can use your magic to pull the Brambles apart.
So can AJ and Pinky.
What about everybody?
Not everything is about Twilight.
No, there's too many of them. It would take too much magic.
Twilight, stop being a wussy.
And quit being a wussy!
A wussy? What's a wussy?
Yep.
Again.
Definitely a metaphor for puberty.
You are in charge!
Kaioken!
Believe! 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 Believe!
What is so loud?
Pilot episode flashback, anyone?
You know, I'm gonna say this is the Endogens. I said Endogens!
So, the gems are the elements of harmony? The seven?
You doing something?
It's morphin' time!
Yeah!
New from Hasbro, it's the mighty Morphin Sailor Scouts of Equestria! Now with 20% sharper shoulders! Available now only at Target!
And also available on Kmart and Big W, also percent off! And also, people love to see it. You know, I'm gonna say this one. What happened to Luna in Celestia's forms? If I say the Power Ranger, I had to be the one of the Power Ranger.
Smell it? It's all the money from toys Hasbro will be making after this movie comes out.
Merchandise is
delicious.
You will buy our toys. You will.
I won't do that. My glasses will protect me. Sorry, Dot.
Okay, girl.
Sorry, Dr. Wolf. My glasses will protect me. You won't ever commence. And that's why you don't do any hypnotize before.
DBZ called. He said your number of level ups were getting ridiculous.
I guess I just leave you with my blind reaction again.
You know, I'm gonna say the Lunar Ranger. You know, I'm gonna say it like this. Let's do it! Lunar Ranger, Power Ranger, ha! Like, you know, you can make a new Power Ranger for the new series. I wish I have a new Power Ranger come out sooner. Where will I think about it?
Oh my god, no! Okay, it doesn't look too bad. It doesn't look too bad, but still. It looks better than the rainbow transformation, for sure.
Yeah.
It's a magical girl.
Gloriosa, are you okay?
Oh my god, it's raining magic! Maybe if we taste it, we'll get powers too!
No.
oh, like marketing!
Wait, are you... Hey, Fesme, are you okay? You about to choke. Why did it keep going through my mouth? Baby orbs. Baby what?
Shifted over to the Equestria Girls universe.
Okay, on second thought, wearing those outfits on a regular basis kind of looks...
Baby orbs. They're just called
silly.
Baby orbs.
I mean...
It's fine.
Sorry, the crystal wing thingies on the back and glasses in the hair do, like... They kind of look out of place in a camp, don't you think?
Glasses.
Gorgeous! And we'll totally go with the other collection I was working on for the camp.
Human sacrifice.
Again, thank you. How could you do this so far? What are you doing?
What have they done to you?
The Lockets of Harmony.
How could he
doesn't have the same ring as the Elements of Harmony.
What happened? It can be...
Maybe we can get them to help save it.
Apparently it's smart.
Oh, like a fundraiser? Or a ball?
Having the whole ball sequence is cliche. It's kind of stupid. It's a contrived way to actually have the band play at the very end of the movie so that, you know, you can have new outfits and stuff.
Yep.
Sure, why not?
I guess. Well, he's enjoying it.
And he's... the penultimate song is in the style of Katy Perry's Firework.
Yeah. I
really love the variety and song choices for this movie.
Okay, I can buy how AJ was in the end okay with the design variety put on for the fashion show, but... Dress is literally frou-frou. No!
Rarity can just make diamonds now?
Also for Pokemon version. Yay. Remember the diamonds version for Pokemon? That was her, some make jewelry, like diamonds, like pink diamonds.
She's gonna tank the Earth's economy!
Work, Bulk, work.
Even like, Wumba Banda style.
So into it! Oh my god, I love it so much!
Sad truth, I would be one of those guys. Most likely back biceps.
And for helping us raise enough money to...
Everfree?
Save Camp Everfree!
Now, if you notice this crowd, there's like one or two adults. So, did those two adults alone, you know, fundraise... save the camp, as in pay off all of its, you know, debts and stuff.
We'll get you back next time, Mr. Remington. You will be back if I will get the camp in here right now. You're not gonna be the decide of the power fashion of the Everfree Swords camp anymore.
Is that Timber and Gloriosa's dad right there? Also, why is Filthy walking away all grumpled? I mean, he
because
got
he's...
the overdue payment that he asked for.
Bomon and Lyra, good job, thank you.
And here I was hoping we'd still be able to hang out.
Don't even try again.
Maybe get dinner and catch a movie?
Please or pray, Lord, can he actually get a movie about something? Can you use, like, the Star Wars Rogue One for this one, please? Put in a movie in it.
Timber has officially taken over the role.
Please, no, not again. Yep. Yep, it goes. Please, don't do that video.
I appreciate that Flash had to learn to let go. I really wish more kids would actually teach that kind of lesson.
Now watch the fandom get mad because someone stole their waifu.
No.
Shit.
Oh, go in the anime.
Oh.
Yeah!
Of course you messed this thing up.
Aw, come on! Just once! I like someone
in
the main six to
Lockalypse! About that, but is that someone gonna help with anime for Demon Lord for now?
I mean, this is the first headership I'm actually on board with!
First of all, isn't this the most amazing freeze frame in the entire movie? Second, how old are Timber and Gloriosa again? I would have
said in
the 20s maybe, but given how crazy laws in America dating minors, correct me if I'm wrong, but him putting the roof on Twilight could get him arrested in the US, right?
Whoa,
touch hands.
Da
dee bum dum. And it bit smile when he got blushes.
Wondering about
Where did the magic that hit this cave come from?
Yes! Yes! This is a question! Yeah, please give me an answer!
It's gonna be the thing again. Okay. I want to see again.
Another tie. The portal thingy.
You mean like the Power Rangers crystals right there?
Oh, I smell sequel.
Multiple sequels confirmed.
Da-da-da!
One for each of those magic trails.
Well, well. Out of everything in this entire film, it's the hook for Equestria Girls 5 that finally gets me invested in this series again. Just imagine if they had to visit Equestria in order to solve a problem. It'll still be a far more interesting setting than high school. Or summer camp.
Because of power crystals, that means they're like energems or anything else's?
So yeah, please, let's combine universes.
Timber wasn't lying. A true Picasso of macaroni art.
The macaroni with the pepperoni. You know, I'm saying this is a really good macaroni thing. It's my favorite part.
We may rag on Celestia and Luna being useless in the first three movies, but you know your character was useless when you find yourself listed under guest voice performers.
Yes.
You finished. I think you mean the Dark.
The Dog of Shame.
Oh, tomato, tomato.
Kiss already!
Oh god, no! In the cover! Everybody, in the cover! God, everybody, in the cover! Except I'm gonna blame Bajai for this one again. Except, oh my god, look at Spike's head, like, flipped. Why?
This was done an ending gag right.
Okay, okay. The after credits gag got a really good laugh.
Yeah, he did it to something like that.
Huh. I never thought I'd have to change up this joke, but... God damn it, Pinky!
Contention. Oh, hold on. I need to go to somewhere. I'll be right back. I'll be arrested. I need some air. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm still okay. I'm back, and I went to the bathroom. And my stomach doesn't feel right because... It kind of hurt very bad, but I just ate something for breakfast. Let's continue about Lissy Condition. Let's talk about what's a condition, what these people, what's it talking about?
What did I just watch?
What did I watch? How many times I went like, I just react your video to you reacted to this analysis reacts by the Legend of Equestria. Oh my god! Look at his face! His face! Look! His eyes is wide, the eyebrows lend down like a baron, his mouth, teeth got smiled. It's like you're in something for Chuck E. Cheese something for that
so,
face.
Equestria Girls Legend of Everfree.
Yes. Any cases?
I gotta say, that movie was pretty dope.
It's okay.
I think that was slightly worse than I thought it was gonna be, but it wasn't as bad as it could have been.
More and more, Rainbow Rocks is feeling like a fluke.
You know,
that was just good, whereas Legends of Equestria Sable is Fox? Good for a movie meant for little kids.
So I give this about a solid 8 out of 10. I think this movie did some good improvements since last movie. We got some good character development with Psytwine. Sunset got some good stuff to do.
Human Twilight's inner struggle was awesome. The final moments of her friends motivating her was beautiful and done a lot better than another character's inner struggle.
No, it's not in the play yet. He didn't do it to Rescued.
Being a fan of superhero movies, comics, and whatnot, obviously I also got a lot out of this. I mean, we basically had the X-Men here, with Sunset being Professor X, with Pinky being Jubilee.
I admit, on my first viewing, the only song that really stood out for me was The Midnight in Me. I mean... That one I felt was the most powerful, while the rest were just kind of generic. Still not on par with the music of Rainbow Rocks, but I do like the variety of them.
From the folk song, to the piano ballad, to the country song, to the pop rock.
Might be my second favorite. Love the characters, love that the villain wasn't totally obvious, there was a little bit of a twist to it.
She is a fantastic villain. There's a quote that's the story of every villain.
Yes, ever film?
Hero gone wrong.
Yeah.
It barely ever has been so true as it has been in this movie. We have somebody who comes from an absolutely realistic background.
I just holding that microphone is like this part.
Has the most noble intentions, but being put into a desperate situation and corrupted by magic, and she turns into this being having issues telling right and wrong apart by imprisoning everybody in order to protect them.
I don't think Josh Hammer had anything to do with this movie.
No, actually,
this
not.
This is like all new writers, and it feels, this movie feels like a new season of Pony.
I think they genuinely had a good concept, and they took a legitimate artistic risk, namely trying to do this new mystery thing.
Well,
I don't see even kids being thrown off by Timber's red herring thing.
You know,
overall, the songs were catchy. Sunset rightfully beats the magic is bad and awful notion out of everyone.
Character dialogue was great in this movie. Sunset and Twilight had some good moments. Timber and Twilight, their conversations demonstrated that the show can do flirty small talk really well.
That's right, that's the point. That's the point, voice of reason. That's the good point.
Overall is kind of uneventful, but I still consider it second best just for effectively replacing Flashlight with a pairing that actually has some chemistry.
Timber feels like the Flash Sentry that was always meant to exist.
The fact that there is still a romantic subplot that takes time away from the other girls is still stupid, but at least the characters involved are not completely and utterly useless. And
yeah, exactly. She said the characters are a bit useless, and then that happens.
Yes, honestly, they did flesh Flash out a lot more, and I am genuinely pleased with that. I still think his character adds nothing to the series, and he never should have existed in the first place. Hashtag, I am not obligated to like the characters you like. Hashtag, deal with it.
Why don't you just, like, you just forgot, like, hashtag, get a room or something.
I certainly had plenty of moments that made me chuckle, and, I was invested in some of the characters, but I don't know, they didn't have as much going for it
like,
as compared to the other films. It might have had fewer problems than something like Friendship Games, but it had fewer standout moments at the same time.
Spike was pointless in this movie.
Yeah. I remember him being the best part of the first movie, so it's kind of sad that he's just been demoted to a squirrel chaser for this film.
The first and second acts are kind of a big jumbled mess. Legends of Everfree also doesn't use their antagonists particularly well.
Except that he's right, but I think addition with the characters and not even trying to find a way, but he forgot of it, you know, like he said.
First off, they split up the job between Filthy Rich, Gloriosa, and Midnight Sparkle, and only one of them is actually worth it.
There have been a few minor issues I could nitpick about, like tiny pacing thingies, aspects that were a little bit too on the nose, jokes that were a little bit too childish.
Not really too big on Gloriosa and Timber, and the rest of the Humane Five were just kind of there.
Once again, it's all about Twilight and Sunset, and the other five are basically there to do nothing. And whoever wrote Rarity's dialogue here, fire them immediately.
Yeah, exactly. Good idea. Fire her away for that word. Get out of here. Get out of here, you stupid word thing.
That match was over in like 30 seconds. Transform, defeat villain, sell toys, done.
I'm not...
Merchandise is too.
...fully on board with them just now suddenly getting powers because of crystals, because this is like, what, the third or fourth time that we've introduced new elements to have these characters have more and more magic. It's just like we can't go one movie without there being some kind of magic involved.
Going into this, I was worried that Equestria Girls wouldn't work as a solo entity, and sadly, I think that fear may have been justified. But, on the other hand, Legends of Everfree isn't actually bad. It's just messy and not very interesting. This is the definition of a C-level effort.
This film didn't really do much for me. I mean, not to say it's bad per se, but just kind of average.
I'd still say the best in the series is hands down Rainbow Rocks.
Overall, I'd say this is the second best movie in the Equestria Girls franchise, right under Rainbow Rocks.
Yeah, like he's gonna do when he's doing the top 5 thing or something, or top 4.
It's basically down to number 4 versus number 2, and I guess I have to rewatch the old one before I can make an actual verdict, but I would say it's up there.
He's gonna make a new movie for... Also, someone had to make a new movie for 5. They're gonna be in the top 5 for this one, for the videos or anything, movies.
It's felt a lot smoother. I don't see any issue with characters. Pacing issues are very tiny, if anything. The visuals are great, so might be my favorite one of the Quest for Gold movies.
Hey, still pretty good.
Yeah.
It was alright. It was our film.
This movie is great. I think it is fine with the awesome song and even the awesome animation. Yeah, except the animation is great. The kissy fog. But now we even like hold together and put it together like that.
There's one more thing in this movie that I really did like that still impresses me. Four films have gone by with varying levels of disasters. Yet Vinyl Scratch still doesn't give a shit.
Well, the final didn't do anything. He just listened to music the whole time. What did he listen for? He did, like, something. He can tell me that the music and listens like a rock band or something.
Best human.
I don't know. I still enjoy giving this one a watch. Don't know if I'd ever watch it again, but yeah, I think it was fun for one-time viewing.
And now, time to transform back.
Again. Hallelujah. And you got wine, biscuit, books, stuff. What are you doing? What are you doing? You forgot to turn off the camera? Or you didn't get clothes change?
Still here? I was talking about my room, transforming my room back.
So I'll give you hell with that change.
Bye.
Bye. I guess he's gone. Yep. Yep, exactly, got a point. So I'm gonna answer the question anything else is before. So yeah. So guys, I think it is done, and I thought this video is great and also funny and also references and stuff. So apparently it did a lot of work for this. So anyway guys, this video will be put in the description below. Even one little channel too. I'll put the description too. Who just made? But anyways, thanks for you guys watching. I'll see you in the next video. Take care of yourself, and I'll see you in the next reacts. Goodbye. And Jose, my voice microphone is finally done. It's great news. Bye.